Hello, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're back to the Star Wars reviews, taking a look at a set I was dying to get my hands on since the moment it was announced. The brand new 75305 Imperial Scout Trooper helmet. This set is listed at $50, has 471 pieces, and is marketed for 18+. The box, like all of the helmets in this series, is very clean looking with a nice red aura highlighting the image of the model on the front. The Imperial insignia and title of the model is also in the top center in its usual sleek white font. One side of the box also shows a more direct front profile of the build on a jet black background. Moving to the rear of the box, we get another angled side profile with a light blue aura this time. On the bottom are a couple of images of the trooper from the movies with a height measurement of the model in the center. The last side of the box appears to be translated languages for international builders and collectors. The build experience, like all of these helmets I've built so far, is super straightforward, and you definitely don't need to be 18 to purchase and enjoy this model, though it is marketed towards adults. I find that much like the Boba Fett helmet, the rounding on the top and sides prominently advertises that this is a Lego set and not your typical plastic model. The lack of tiling also simplifies the build and adds a bit of depth to the exterior. One thing I'm noticing while building this series of sets is the opportunity to get a lot of really nice pieces with studs on the side, as well as a lot of smaller pieces in the colors that these sets are built in, if you're just buying it for the pieces, that is, which you could probably get better value for elsewhere. Moving on to the model overview, we'll start with the front. The printed LEGO Star Wars Scout Trooper plate is on the bottom here and is awesome already for not making me put a sticker on it. Let's go ahead and get a quick 360 of the entire model to get an idea of what it all looks like put together with all the stickers applied. The cheeks, respirator, and visor are all partially tiled and proportional to the original character with a bit of recess behind the black bricks on the front here. The sides are also partially tiled and have a series of stickered rounded tiles wrapping all the way around the back to the other side. The rear has some gray highlights in the top third to contrast the white, and the left side has this gray and white sticker on the bottom of the visor, but otherwise mirrors the right side. Overall, there's not a lot else to really say. This build is solid, and for $10 less at least than all the other helmets, this is definitely the go-to for anyone on a budget. It's designed with collectors in mind, and it's still relatively friendly to less experienced builders. I gotta say, it's hard to go wrong with this one, but what do you guys think? Which one is your favorite so far in the helmet series? Let me know in the comments. Thank you all so much for watching to the end. If you enjoy this kind of content, I'd love to hear from you in the comments, and a like is greatly appreciated. Please follow Closed on Sunday for the awesome music, link in the description, it wouldn't be possible without him, and I will see you all next time.